Hello guys, welcome to my video on top innovative RTS games of all time. In this video, we will taking a look at some of the most innovative and influential RTS games of all time, exploring their unique features and contribution to the genre. So, sit back, relax, and let's start our journey. Set in the Dune universe, Dune 2 introduced the foundational elements of the RTS genre. Assassin's Creed Dune 2 is the archetypal real-time strategy game. Striking a balance between complexity and innovation, it was a huge success and laid the foundation for RTS games that followed. Players control one of three factions and engage in real-time combat, resource gathering, base building, and unit control. The game features a story inspired by Frank Herbert's novel with the objective of mining the valuable spice melange. Dune 2 innovated by combining strategic resource management with fast-paced gameplay, setting the stage for future RTS titles. It is regarded as a classic and marked at the beginning of the RTS genre evolution. The next game is Total Annihilation. This is the first RTS game that innovate with its large-scale battles and extensive unit customization option. This is a first RTS that have 3D visuals for both units and terrain. It was innovative for its time, along with a complex resource economy system. You will fight the enemy on the land, sea, and air that make this game have a diverse complement of unit types. The game story is also interesting. So, in the distant future, the galaxy is ruled by central body of humans and artificial intelligence called the Core. But then there is a conflict raging up between the humans and the Core, and gonna happen to next 4,000 years. Total Annihilation set the bar for strategic depth and scale in RTS games, pushing the boundaries of what was possible. Next is Homeworld, the first RTS game to take place in a fully 3D space, allowing players to move their units in any direction and on any plane. This adds a new level of complexity to the gameplay and required players to think in 3 dimensions. The game's single-player mode consists of a story-driven campaign broken up into levels. This was a departure from a traditional RTS format of individual missions with no overarching narrative. Homeworld have great graphics and sound design. It is described the space very good at the time. Homeworld's gameplay was deep and polished, with a focus on gathering resources, building military force, and using them to destroy enemy force and accomplish objective. Overall, Homeworld's innovative use of 3D space, story-driven campaign, and polished gameplay helped to set a new standard for the RTS genre and influence many games that followed. Move the next, Rise of Nations is a fusion of turn-based and real-time strategy, offering a unique gameplay experience. Unlike other historical real-time strategy games, it spans the entirety of history from ancient times to the modern age, allowing players to explore various era and civilization. Rise of Nations brought new features like territory and attrition, setting it apart from other real-time strategy games. Its innovative gameplay received praise for its strategic depth and balance between real-time and turn-based mechanic. The game also had a variety of units, buildings, and weapon effects. These qualities earned Rise of Nations the 2003 Best Real-Time Strategy Game award from PC Gamers US and a runner-up spot for Best Game of 2003. Next, we have World in Conflict. This RTS is known for its fast-paced, action-packed gameplay that emphasizes tactical decision-making over resource management. Unlike many other RTS games, World in Conflict is set in a modern Cold War era world, which allows for a unique blend of real-world military technology and fictional scenario. The game's single-player campaign is highly regarded for its engaging story, well-developed characters, and cinematic presentation. World in Conflict's multiplayer mode was praised for its innovative tug-of-war gameplay, which involves capturing and holding strategic points on the map. The game's graphics were considered top-notch for its time, with detailed environments, realistic explosions, and impressive special effects. Its unique blend of action, strategy, and storytelling help it stand out from other games in the genre and cement its place as a classic of the RTS genre. Next, we have Supreme Commander. The game was designed to be strategy focused due to its large scale. Supreme Commander is a large-scale RTS where players control armies of hundreds of units. The game has a unique design system that lets players create and experiment with different weapon and equipment combinations. Its key innovation is the strategic zoom inspired by Dungeon Siege. The strategic zoom lets players view the whole battlefield and focus on specific units or area, reducing micromanagement. Supreme Commander's gameplay advances as players start with basic units and resources and gradually build up their armies and base during the match. Overall, it introduces innovative features and gameplay mechanics, setting it apart from other RTS games with its large scale. Customizability, strategic zoom, and scalability is worth to try. On the next are Company of Heroes. Revolutioned the RTS genre with its realistic and immersive gameplay, introducing innovative mechanics such as tactical cover system, dynamic line of sight, and destructible environments. It emphasizes tactical gameplay, requiring players to keep their units alive, use cover, and utilize special abilities and gain further experience that translate into new advantages on the battlefield. Company of Heroes was one of the first Direct 10 games using the new API to improve shadow and lightning quality, and the game used cutting-edge technology to improve the game's graphic and lightning quality. Overall, Company of Heroes is an innovative RTS game that introduced several new features to the genre, such as tactical gameplay, experienced veterans, Direct 10, cutting-edge technology, and a variety, location, and depth of content. Anno 1404 combines line-driving mechanics with traditional RTS elements, creating a new and innovative gameplay experience. The game also features new gameplay mechanics that combines elements from various genres, such as RTS, CCGs, and tabletop strategy games. Anno 1404 takes place in a unique setting, the Orient, which was not commonly explored in RTS games at the time of its release. The game features a complex economic system that requires players to manage resources and trade routes to maintain their empire. Anno 1404 features an updated interface, bigger island, and worlds to explore, a sandbox mode, and other features new to the Anno series. Overall, Anno 1404's innovative gameplay mechanics, unique setting, complex economic system, update interface, and multiplayer mode make it a standout title in the RTS genre. Grey Goo has great gameplay and a modern look that make it an excellent traditional RTS. Grey Goo has an enhanced interface that makes it easier to control everything from unit production to base building with the stroke of a few hotkeys. You start the game with a single mother of goo, a huge armor boss blob that can consume other units to grow and replicate. This makes the Goo faction unique compared to the other faction in the game. Grey Goo is a throwback to the simplistic storylines of the RTS games of old. The gameplay is also reminiscent of classic RTS games like Command & Conquer and Dune 2. Overall, Grey Goo is an innovative RTS game that combines classic gameplay with modern design and gameplay elements and introduce new and unique factions like the Goo. Known for its focus on large-scale battles and strategic depth, it introduced innovative features like the ability to control thousands of units simultaneously, punishing the limits of RTS gameplay. The game features massive battles involving thousands of units on vast battlefields, which is far greater than most other games of its kind. Age of the Singularity was the first video game to implement DirectX 12 support, which allowed for better graphics and performance. Overall, Age of Singularity is considered an innovative RTS game due to its ability to handle massive scale battles with thousands of units on the screen at the same time, which was made possible by the game's innovative Nitrous engine and DirectX 12 support. So that's our line of top 10 most innovative RTS games of all time. Thank you for joining me for my video on the top innovative RTS games of all time. We hope you enjoy our list and discovered some new games to try out. So, if you find this video useful or entertain you, please hit the thumbs up and share my video, or subscribe to my channel for more content like this. So, see you guys in the next video. Thanks!